OBS Studio users,
why aren't you using the basic transitions?
Streamers will either have a custom stinger transition or no transitions at all.
And then I'll get compliments on my basic slide transition. It's there, it's free. Let me show you.
So here's my stream setup. I'm in my full screen mode or my just chatting mode. And if I switch to the game, boom, there's gonna be this melting transition, right? This is a default transition. I didn't have to install anything fancy for that. If you go down here to set transition, you're gonna see that I have Luma Wipe. And if I click on the cog wheel to transition properties, then go to properties, within that one transition option, you have all of that. Now, of course, there's a bunch of them that are gonna be cheesy. I wonder if there's Star Wipe, that would be cool. The one I use in particular is called Sinus 9, and the only thing is that I put it to 2000 milliseconds, so 2 seconds, so it's kind of slow, but not too slow. We can preview a bunch of them, we can preview all of them actually. Barn door, bottom left, preview transition. It would be like this. Okay, so now we know what barn door is. We can do box bottom left. Okay, not as interesting, but it's something, right? If you don't have a transition at all, it's something. Burst, is that star? Not quite. You can actually adjust the softness, which I didn't even realize. So if I put a high value, it's gonna be very faded, very feathered. But one seems to be the top value. Preview again. Oh, very soft, super soft. All right, 0.03 was nice. Checkerboard small. Circles. I don't like that one. But you can use it if you like it. That's clock, ew. Cloud. Hey, this one, I actually used that one for a specific overlay pack presentation. But if I have this now, I click okay, and I switch to my full screen. That's a pretty cool effect, and it's free. It comes default with OBS. Use it. All right, we're not done. Okay, cogwheel properties again. Curtain. Okay, okay. Fan, which I need right now because it's so hot. Ew. I shouldn't be judging them. You should be deciding which one you like, but it's funny. Oh, fractal. I kind of like that. I kind of like that. So 2 seconds to 3 seconds makes it look more professional in a way. Iris. Okay, it's basic. Linear horizontal, you get it, it's linear wipe. Parallel zigzag horizontal, that's a mouthful. Oh, sinus 9, of course, is what it looks like. Really like it. By the way, you can also invert them. I don't know if you saw that. Boom, so it's, well, you're not gonna see a difference here. But basically, instead of opening up in a way, you see like B is basically bursting through in a way, it does the opposite. It melts away in a way. Maybe there's a better example. Spiral. Okay, see how it spirals in? If I click invert, it's gonna spiral out. That's the big difference. Squares. That was square. Now that's squares. There you go, multiple squares. I don't like that. Stripes. I don't like it either. Strips. Hey, not too bad. Watercolor. This one is nice. This one is nice. If you put this one to like 4 milliseconds, it's gonna be very slow, but it's probably gonna look good. I like that. I would use that. This is great. Let's go back. And then there's zigzag horizontal. And you'll understand what zigzag vertical is in that case. There you go. And that is just with the Luma Wipe option. You come here, you can add Luma Wipe. If you add something like swipe, click OK. You also have a couple of options. Not as much, of course. This is just a swipe, basically. I like using that one too, especially when it's slow like that. It looks kind of professional. Let me show you. Look at that. It's gonna push the screen away. I used that when I used to stream using slobs, and people were like, how did you get this effect? And what plugin are you using? And I'm like, this is default. This is default. Just, but there's also slide. And the difference between swipe and slide is that instead of pushing just one out of the way, the other one is also coming in like this. So the other one is attached and it's going in. Minor difference, but still looks good in my opinion, especially when it's slow like that. There's fade to color, which I don't really use. Personally, I don't like it, but it basically fades into whatever color you want it to fade to. So I don't know if you have a color scheme, I wouldn't use that. Don't use that one. Leave that one alone. Look at this, fade to blue and then fade back into, I don't like that one at all. Maybe if it's fast, I guess.
Let's put 1 second. Nope. No me gusta. Okay, that's the only one you're not allowed to use because it looks so awful. And then of course we have Stinger Transition. Those are like the custom made where you can put like your logo and all that. I actually have some of them that are completely free on gumroad.com/guide-level. So check them out. Make sure you read the product description. God damn it. And then there's Add Shader. But I believe this is a custom Luma wipe transitions. So basically you're gonna put like a black and white animation and it's gonna play with the transparency, kind of like what we have with normal Luma wipe, except you're gonna have to be the one to animate this and then input it. Anyways, talking about Stinger Transition, this is the one that I made in my previous video. Check it out. Watch that video to know basically how to get access to it and how to use it for free. So yeah, this was a quick rant and also a demonstration of all the default OBS transitions that you have. If you like the video, make sure you subscribe. Bye-bye.